Hello Inventors, so in this video I'm going to show you how we can read data using Google Sheet in MIT App Inventor. So we can see we have the data like this, okay, roll number and the percent. Now you can see we have the search functionality using the Google Sheet in MIT App Inventor. Here you can search any student result, you just need to put their roll number. So suppose 107 is a roll number, you'll see here we have the roll numbers here. Now I'm going to just search 107, so I should get the 91% in my app. Let's click on the search option and you will see the 91%. You can just change the roll number here. Let's search and you will see the 38%. Using this functionality, you can see 38%. Using this functionality, you can create the dictionary app that have the data in the Google Sheet. You can do a lot more thing with this amazing functionality. So let me show you how we can create this app step by step here. So first of all, we need to click on new project. And my project name is read data. Here you can see we have the first screen. I'm going to change the screen name screen one to the read data. So I need here one text box, okay, for the searching. So just drag and drop here one text box like this. And I'm going to add one button and I'm going to add one label to display the data. And I'm going to make all the things in a center. So click on a screen and make this thing align horizontal and the vertical should be in a center like this. I'm going to click on the text box and to remove that hint text and just say here search or search result like this. And I'm going to make that width is at least 70% like this. I'm going to change that button width is also 70%. I'm going to change the text of that button to something search. I'm going to make that font bold and make that font size at least 16. I'm going to change the background color of that screen to something that you love. So suppose let's go to the custom and let's pick random from here. Click on done. Now we have that data. Now we have that search button. If you want to change the search button background color, so click on this and let's search, change it to the pink. No, it's not aligned with the background color. So let's go to the custom and let's make it some darker color. And make that text color white. Good. Now click on that label and just say here change the text is like result and make this font size at least 20. Make it font bold like this. Got it. In the left side you'll find the option of connectivity and you will see the web option. Just drag and drop that web component here. Now we need to create one Google Sheet. You can just create the Google Sheet. So I'm going to just create new spreadsheet like this. Here you can define any name of that sheet like result TCB like this. Now here you need to just put the value is like A is something roll number and second one is the result. We need to put the number. You can add the dictionary value like the word and here in the second column is the meaning. So suppose let's put the 101 like this. Now we have the data. Now that's the most important task. Now in the right side, you'll find the share option. Click on it. And we need to just change this restricted to the anyone with this link. And we need to just select the view and select the copy link. Now we need to paste that link in any notepad. Now you can see this is the notepad. I'm going to just paste that link. And we need to do one thing here, remove the text like sharing, equal, USP and the edit also. Now we have that URL, okay, of our sheet. We just need to write some word like export question mark format equal CSV. Okay, now this is our full URL. Now just copy that URL, go to the MIT App Inventor project, click on the web and just paste that URL here. Okay, what we have done, let me just tell you, let me just copy this and what's the difference between edited one and the previous one. Both link is same till that ID. After this, you will see the edit question mark. We need to just instead of this export question mark format equals CSV that we have to done and we need to copy that URL. Okay, like this, just copy that URL and paste that URL in the web in the URL option here. Okay, now after this let's go to the block section. If someone searched something, So we need to get the data. So first of all, we need to get a normal data list. So we will create one variable is like result, and I'm going to create the empty list. Click on the list and see the empty list. Once the screen will initialize, so click on the screen and you will see here, once the screen will initialize, we'll call the var get data. Click on the var and you will see here the get. This will get the data. Okay, we'll fetch the URL. We'll fetch the data from the URL that we have set in the designer. Go to the designer, you will see in the web URL, this one. Now go to the block, click on the web again, and you'll see the got the text. Once we got the text, so we need to assign that text to something. So I'm gonna assign that text to the result list. It's a list, okay? So I'm gonna assign that text response content, this one, got it. After getting the data, we need to display that specific data. So for that, once the people click on the button one, so now we need to run here the for each loop to get one where one data. So I'm going to click on the control, use the for each loop like this, drag and drop it here. And which is the list? List is our this one result. This is our list. We'll get the one where one data in this loop. Now we need to use the again control and use the condition. If that item contains some text that is equal to the text box one dot text, because we have the roll number in the text box one dot text. Now click on the text and you will see here the content text, this one. Now I'm going to use here the condition like content text and the which from the which text from the item. If that item contain the text of text box one dot text, then we'll display the label value, set label. And we need to fetch the second value from that. Like after the fetching the value, we'll get the this one result, this one line. So we need to fetch the result only. So for that, click on the list and pick the index value, like select list item, list and the index. So list, which is the list? List is the item, this one. And we need to fetch the index. It means the value 2. Index 2. We need to go to the list and you will see here the option of list from the CSV table text. So list from the CSV table text, this one. Make sure we need to put that value here like this. Okay, now let's go to here and put the here 102, click on the search option. And here you can see we have the result is 54%. You can just search 101 and click on search. This is 92%. So that's the overall app that we have created using the MIT App Inventor. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.